Hi, everyone. Aaron here for zollotech, and iOS 13 Developer Beta 5 and Public Beta 4 have been out for a few days now. I've been using it primarily on my iPhone XS Max, along with my iPad Pro 12.9. These are my main devices that I use it on. However, I do have it on some older devices as well, but that's partly why I do the YouTube community poll, is to see how it is for all the other devices, because I can't use them all full time. So I use this one as my full-time device right now, and as far as the XS Max, and then sometimes I switch between the XR and some older ones, but a lot of you commented in the YouTube community poll that we'll take a look at in a little while, and that gives me an idea of how it is overall. So I've taken down everything you've said, along with some notes that I've kept over the week as I've been using it, and I thought we'd talk about my experience, then we'll talk about your experience, and then we'll take a look at the YouTube community poll. Now, this beta has been kind of strange. It's actually had more lockups for me than the previous one. Sometimes I'd be using it and it would completely freeze. It would just lock up. It's actually locked up twice like that. It just wouldn't do anything for a good 5 to 10 seconds. And then it would work again. I haven't had a lockup in settings like we used to have, but for some reason it just keeps locking up here and there. I've also had it respring once on me, which means I was just using it, maybe going into settings, and the screen goes black and then it reboots. So without turning off the whole device, but it resprings the main display. And so that has been kind of not a great experience compared to the last beta. Now, they have fixed a lot of bugs in this one, and mostly it works well for me. However, mail, I've gone back to using the stock mail app, and I like it quite a lot. But the problem with it is sometimes that freezes as well. Sometimes it's missing email and notifications are not coming in. So with the changes they made to it, I really enjoy this version of email, but they really need to fix that before it's ready to go in September. Now, another weird issue I had, I was unable to open my messaging app as well. And I actually had to turn the display off, tap the screen and turn it back on. Then I could go into messages. Others I've known have had this issue and have actually had to reboot. So there's something weird going on there. And it's just kind of an odd experience. The same is true on the iPad. The iPad has been a similar experience. And while it works well, for the most part, things like YouTube occasionally have touch responsiveness issues again. So I'll go into YouTube, the touch won't work, then I'll turn the screen off, turn it back on, and I have the same experience over and over and over. So something has changed fundamentally that I'm sure they'll fix in a future update, but at this time it's still kind of what it was before as far as that goes. Now, as far as the battery is concerned, now with betas, battery can be great, sometimes not so great. But let's take a look at it. It's been okay for me so far, and I do have 100% battery health. This is a newer phone, like I've said before, and this tells you the best case scenario, at least how I'm using the iPhone. So you can see here, this was probably my best, and that's kind of the day of or day before I switched to the beta, or day of, I guess. 5 hours and 54 minutes of screen on time, 2 hours and 11 minutes of screen off time. If we take a look at yesterday, or today is probably a better indication, it's 2:43 in the afternoon, 3 hours and 22 minutes of screen on time, 1 hour and 4 minutes of screen off time. And I currently have 57% battery life. So I get through a day still without a problem normally, but it's not amazing battery life. And I would expect it to get much better as we get closer to the final release. But just keep in mind with the different apps that I'm using here, it can vary as far as the experience is concerned. Now, most people that participated in the YouTube community poll said that battery life was good for them. Most people, not everyone though. And also a lot of people said it was very fast and smooth, no issues. Although some people were looking whether or not Fortnite would still crash. And I know people are still having crash issues with games, including Fortnite as well. Now, every device seems to be behaving the same. They all seem to have decent performance, opening different apps, going in and just scrolling and things like that. Your basics are working well. And a couple people said they had weird camera issues, but for the most part, it's been a pretty solid experience for most people. The one thing I am hearing a lot has to do with the Apple Watch though. And if you are not on the beta of Apple watchOS 6, chances are you probably have pretty poor battery life with your Apple Watch, strangely, if you're on watchOS 5. So if you're on watchOS 5 connected to iOS 13, people are saying battery life is really poor. I'm on watchOS 6 and battery life is at 72%. almost 3 in the afternoon, so it's actually pretty good for me. Now, as far as RAM management is concerned, I had just opened YouTube and I had to reopen it. It reloaded. So I don't necessarily consider that RAM management. There's other things going on, but apps are not staying open in the background like they normally would. But let's take a look at the YouTube community poll. So 10,000 of you voted on this, so I really appreciate it. And there's 200 comments at the time I'm reading this, and I've read every single one of them, so I really appreciate that. And as we see here, 35% of you said that it was great. So that's a good sign. And only 3% said it was terrible. That's an all-time low, I believe, for any of the polls that I've run. 18% said okay, but some bugs. 35% of you are using basically public release versions, and 9% are using Android. And I include Android just so we'll maybe do some Android videos like this in the future. It depends how many people want to see that. So I went through all of these different comments, and many people said it performed pretty well. So let's take a look at 10 or so of these. iPhone XS, great performance, no bugs, great battery life. The only thing they're having a problem with is their Apple Watch battery is draining so fast. In the evening, I normally have around 50% left, and now 20% left. And like I said, people have actually been commenting or contacting me about this with comments regarding the Apple Watch having terrible battery life. So keep that in mind. So iPhone 10 might be the smoothest beta in a while, for myself at least. YouTube finally works on iPadOS. Battery life is great on my iPhone 6S Plus, and speed-wise, it's pretty good for a latest beta so far compared to the previous beta before. I've had great battery life overall with iOS 13 betas so far. I love all the new features, like the new wallpapers, the new volume HUD, and so much more. And so far, iOS 13 has been a great experience to use. Now, this is something I forgot to mention. Few little glitches, like when my phone is in landscape, I lock in the line button is glitchy and doesn't work. Well, a lot of people have been saying that it's actually glitchy when you're on a different app and you rotate it. Some video apps work well, but other apps were not working in landscape. So I thankfully have not had that issue, but quite a few are still having that issue, or at least experiencing it for the first time. iPad 6th gen, this is certainly better than previous beta for me. From performance, less bugs, smooth multitasking, but battery life is okay. 10S Max, it's great. iPhone SE, working fine. I haven't found a single bug yet. It's a good sign. Phone respring sometime. So laggy and apps crash way more frequently than on Dev Beta 4 on an iPhone 6S. iPhone 7, I sometimes can't open Control Center or Notification Center on landscape mode, and sometimes when I type something in landscape, it flashes and the right side of the keyboard doesn't work. It instead thinks that I'm touching few letters to the left. So like I said, issues with landscape for some reason seem to be a common theme here. More crash than public beta 3 on an 8 Plus. It's not okay on my 10R. A lot of bugs, and YouTube is horrible with a lot of bugs on my iPhone froze every time. Again, a lot of people still having issues. Battery was lasting longer on previous public beta 13.3. Some apps are activating iPhone to show as restarting, but not completing the action while showing them lock screen. iPhone 10, it works great for any beta. On my iPad Pro, there are still times when it randomly crashes an app I'm in. Also had a bug with the mail app where after the update, my emails disappeared. However, by force touching the app and choosing all inboxes, they came back. Using iOS 13 Beta 5, iPhone 7 Plus, it's really smooth and normal battery life as iOS 12.4. Let's take a look at a couple more. My bank app still crashes and mail app freezes when moving mail into archive on my 10R. And the last one, can you still downgrade if you're on public Beta 4? Sure, you can downgrade to the previous version of iOS 12.4. iOS 12.3 and 12.3.1 can no longer be downgraded to. And that's really it. I'm enjoying using iOS 13, but again, it's been kind of buggy for me. So I'm looking forward to the next version, and that should be hopefully Monday or Tuesday, or a week from Monday and Tuesday. So either way, we'll see a beta within probably a week by the time you're watching this. Hopefully a couple days by the time you're watching it, but it could be a week. But let me know what you think in the comments below. Of course, I'll link this wallpaper in the description as I always do. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a like. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe and hit that notification bell if you'd like to see more of these videos as soon as they're released. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.